Qui proprium et miserere semper et parcere, propitiare animabus famalorum famalarumque tuarum, et omnia eorum peccate dimite, ut mortalitatis vincudis absolute, transire meriantur ad vitam, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Somnium fidelium defunctum, ab omnium in cui, grazia Christi, sovereign, gloria, Oh. purposes. All Masses on Monday will be offered for the repose of the souls of those on our November dead list. In addition, we will sing Vespers of the Dead after the 6 p.m. Mass. Women's Oratory meets this Tuesday from 7:45 p.m. in the Parish Centre. Catechism for Adults continues this Thursday at 8 p.m. in the Parish Centre. The theme this week is, Who is Jesus and Why Did He Die? All are very welcome. There are still boxes available at the back of church for the annual Christmas shoebox appeal for presents for poor children throughout the world. Please take one and return it by next Monday, the 21st of November, at the latest. We will not be able to accept any boxes after that date. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. One of the most moving sights during the funeral of the late Queen was perhaps the procession from Westminster Hall to Westminster Abbey, to the stirring sound of pipes and drums playing the mist-covered mountains. 142 naval ratings pulled the gun carriage which carried the coffin of Her Late Majesty. Here was a state funeral with full military honours. And here were 142 men and women who have pledged their very lives to serve their sovereign, the woman whose mortal remains they now carried to her funeral. Dedication, commitment, and service were ideas we heard spoken much of in relation to Queen Elizabeth. But these are something also evident in the lives of all servicemen and women. It was indeed servicemen and women who inspired that remarkable sense of duty in the Queen. The scene that day was striking and brought to mind the fact that there is a wonderful reciprocity in that commitment, which calls to mind the oft-quoted epitaph for the war dead, the words of John Maxwell Edmonds, which goes, When you go home, tell them of us and say, For your tomorrow, we gave our today. That dedication is what brings us here today to pray for the souls of so many who gave their lives in service and dedication to crown and country. In the epistle of our Mass today, we hear recounted from the second book of the Maccabees that to honor the memory of his men, the fallen of the Maccabean revolt, and to plead that their sins may be forgiven them, Judas Maccabeus instructs that a sacrifice be offered in the temple in Jerusalem, that temple that he had cleansed and restored to the right worship of God. That event, one of the theological justifications for our prayer for the dead, reminds us of what a just thing it is, bene et religiose, to pray for the dead that their sins may be forgiven them. But it is particularly poignant that we should have this text today for those fallen in war who have paid the ultimate price. The last and the best thing we can do for them is to pray and offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass. The horror of war, of any war, is something about which we should naturally shudder to think. The loss of life, particularly young life, is not something natural, but is rightly an aberration. But there is something in the offering of themselves, in the many members of the armed forces who have fallen, that selfless dedication to the good of the many, to the country they served so valiantly, which adds a nobility even to the most terrible of deaths in conflict. What greater love has any man, asks our Lord, than to lay down his life for his friends? Greater still, one wonders, if one lays down one's life for those who will never know us. That passage in St. John's Gospel goes on, You are my friends if you do what I command you. For a Christian nation such as ours, and for a Christian people, the heart of any act of service is the example of our Savior, who laid down his life for us in order to bring about his kingdom, now and for eternity, and to win for us heaven. The memory of the many fallen in wars lays an onus on the likes of you and I, that their sacrifice may not have been in vain. More than this, that their sacrifice, which is an imitation of the self-sacrificing love of our Savior, may inspire us who remain to bring about that kingdom of love and truth in a world that still needs it so much, in a world that needs setting free. The legacy of our war dead is a challenge to us. Our land is marked by the weight of their memory. War memorials in every village and town, tablets in churches recording the loss of a generation. Even in our own church, we have such a one. And even the monstrance we use for benediction every Sunday night was given in memory and has the name of a fallen student engraved on its foot. Recalling the memory of the fallen is itself a noble thing, but it is not enough. We remember so that we can do things differently, so that their ultimate sacrifice can inspire us in the daily sacrifices of our lives that change the world that we live in little by little. That air that was played so stirringly at the late Queen's funeral takes its name from a Scottish lament. The words are those of one who is far away, but who longs for the sight of home. The final verse has it: "There shall I gaze on the mountains again, on the fields and the hills and the birds in the glen, with people of courage beyond human ken. In the haunts of the deer I will roam, so loving and kind, full of music and mirth, that sweet-sounding language of home." We pray this morning for those people of courage beyond human ken whom we commemorate, the fallen of the wars. We pray that God's merciful judgment will indeed see them welcomed home. And for our part, we use that sweet-sounding language of heaven in their honor and to encourage all of us to get there too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuum.
Sorsum coda.
Amemus ad Dominum.
Gratias agamus. Domino Deo nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est, ecum et salutare. Nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere. Domine Sancte Pater, omnipotens aeterne Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. In qua nobis spes beate resurrectionis effulsit, ut quos contristat certa moriendi conditio, eostem consoletur future immortalitatis promissio. Tuis enim fidelibus Domine, vita mutatur non tollitur, et dissoluta terrestris, huius incolatus domo, aeterna in celis habitatio comparatu. Et ideo, cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omni militia celestis exercitus, imnum gloriae tuae canimus, sine fine dicentes.
Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Venus in Caeli et Terra Gloria Tua, Hosanna in Excelsis, Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in Excelsis.
Oh,
nobis quoque peccatoribus.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, preceptis salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et tu spiritus tuo.
ecce annus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato me. Domine non sum dignus ut intra esse peccum meum, sed tantum dic verbo ex inhabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus ut intra esse peccum meum, sed tantum dic verbo ex inhabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus ut intra esse peccum meum, sed tantum dic verbo ex inhabitur anima mea.
Thank you. Fiat Eris Domine, cum sanctis tuis in eternum, quia pius est, requiem eternum dona eis Domine, et lux perpetua ducet eis, cum sanctis tuis in eternum, quia pius est.
Dominus vobis.
Et cum spiritus tuo.
Oremus. Deus qui soli competit medicinam prestare post mortem, presta quesumus, ut anime famulorum famularumque tuarum, terrenis exute contagiis, in tue redemptionis parti numerentur. Qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.